Plagiarism. Plagiarism and art theory. What is the first thing that comes to your mind when you hear those words? Maybe the time when you go to DeviantArt and see someone has posted their totally original OC, Do Not Steal TM artwork that in actuality is no more than an obvious and bad recolor of someone else's artwork. You sigh to yourself, and since this is probably the fifth time you have seen something like this, you kinda let it be, since the person who does it is like a 10-year-old kid, and you hope that they can grow out of it and then become a better artist. In today's case, that won't be so simple, because whoa boy, it's gonna be a wild ride. Now, let me make a couple things clear before we get into the meat of things. I am no political channel, nor am I a commentary channel. I am trying to approach this from a perspective of an artist and bring more attention to this whole ordeal. I may be a tiny measly channel, but if I can bring this to attention of even two more people, I'll be happy. There will be a little bit of talk about politics here, and I can hear you asking, how can you make art theory political? Well, you'll see when we get to it, but I try to keep that to minimum and concentrate on the work itself. Most of the sources are in Spanish, since this is something that happened in Argentina, so I also try to tread this path carefully and try not to get any details wrong. So I'm quite sure that I might get something wrong, but you know, just as the disclaimer. There are a few English-speaking channels and YouTubers that have talked about this, whose videos I'll link down below. But I also encourage you to seek out some of the Spanish-speaking channels that have covered this too. I myself watched few of their videos with YouTube's auto-translated captions on and got the general idea of what's going on. I'll also link their videos down below, alongside with the articles and documents that I used when doing a research on this video. I'm not that deep into all of the drama that this has sparked or know every detail. There are better videos who talk about those details more, like example here. I just wanted to make this video and be appalled at how someone has gotten away with something like this for so long. I feel like I'm all over the place with this. Hard to put my feelings into words here. So, today's main star will be Fatima Beshi Caru, an Argentinian artist who came under fire when people started to accuse of her plagiarizing other people's art. It seems that it all started when a Twitter user named @acavoart said she had copied their art of Sunset Shimmer, a My Little Pony character. As you can see, that does not look like a coincidence. Or if it somehow is, then wow, the universe is really weird. Of course, this holding does not end here. There is so much more to come. A wonderful person piled a handy dandy Google Docs that has most of the plagiarized works piled up, and going through them, I was holding my head in my hands. I couldn't fucking believe this shit. She copied Hatsune Miku! I'm not blind, right? That's Hatsune Miku, right? Right? Yes, this hole gets even deeper. There are more than few artists and even animes that she has copied from. Okay, so just to give a little leeway, there are few, and I mean just few, that can sorta be argued that yes, this is using reference correctly or using heavy inspiration, but well, it's obvious that most of them aren't. I mean, yeah, when I was a wee little kiddie and I was starting to get into manga and anime and drawing, I did use a lot of reference from the mangas that I had at the time. And well, the only ones we got were like Dragon Ball and Ranma. I also did trace work then, since I wanted to draw and make my characters look just like Goku or Ranma or any of the other characters. But the difference here with me and this artist Fatima is the fact that I was barely 11. A little child who just drew for their own enjoyment. I never posted those works anywhere or claimed that they were my original Do Not Steal TM work. Fatima Peshikaru is a 37-year-old adult woman whose work has been accepted into museums and people have paid, you heard me correctly, paid for her work. Yeah, there are some blame on the museum too for not making sure that the work she presented wasn't plagiarized, but still, she has no right to play the victim here. Oh yeah, she's the one who claims to be the victim here. According to sources, articles, and her, people have seemingly harassed her and apparently even doxed her. I, to make it clear, do not support this sort of behavior towards anyone. I know what she has done is infuriating and her attitude towards this whole thing is also bad, but this still should be handled with some sort of grace. How she acts towards this whole thing and the accusations, I can understand why some people are peeved. But now, here comes the political part I mentioned earlier. Fatima Peshi is a feminist, and she's not the nice kind of feminist. Understanding the situation, her being a feminist was brought up by a YouTuber, Tipito Enchado, on his YouTube video talking about her. I'm not sure is he the first one to talk about this, but his video has been cited in some of the articles when talking about her. It also seems that her being a feminist has something to do with all of this backlash, so it wasn't brought up just for nothing. Disclaimer, then again, I can be corrected on this. Most of the critique she has gotten, she has brushed off or act like she was the victim by insinuating that those who criticize her are nothing but internet trolls and angry, since she is a strong, independent feminist. Yeah, great way to deal with the situation and anger even more people. You can't just write serious accusations off by saying it's because of sexism and because I'm a woman. Ugh. Sorry if I sounded a little heated. This whole thing has been a huge ordeal and I just can't wrap my head around how she thought that she would never get caught. It's the time of the internet. Internet is full of people ready to do some serious detective work, even just to spite someone. Looking at the art she has plagiarized in the Google Doc, some of it is so obvious and clear direct copies, like, sis, this is not it. She even copied Rumiko Takahashi. Come on. Like, why? Girl, why? You really thought no one would recognize that? Again, if you want to use heavy reference or get inspiration of someone else's work, it's okay, it's fine. But, here comes the big but, this is too much. She has made so much money off basically other people's work. Ugh. I don't want to sound mean either, but most of her work, it doesn't even look that good. I mean, I am no master artist myself, but the colors, the anatomy, this perspective, it all seems a little wonky in places, like, ugh, no. What also makes this whole thing worse is that her art that got into the museum is taking away places from people who would be actually more deserving of that position. I know this is not the end of the drama and the whole situation. There is much, much more to uncover, and I highly recommend, if you are even a little bit interested, to go and search up more information. Again, you can find links down in the description to the sources I myself used. Just try not to get too upset like me. This was a bit of a random video to make, but well, I was curious and wanted kind of just talk about it, since I haven't seen this big of a case of plagiarism in ages, especially one involving anime and this much money. I'm sure someone might correct me on this one too. Thank you for watching. Sorry if I sounded rambly. And cheers for sticking with me this long. The world sure is a crazy place. See ya, bitches.